Degrees for Favour. Degrees for Favour. That's an empowerment that can move a man from where he is to where he wants to be. If success is by work, bricklayers on site, it should be the most successful people on earth. A grace hawker can be exponentially more elevated than an experienced worker. That is something God can put upon a man that can transform them from vain men to great men. Favor is a divine concept that cannot be explained by words of mouth. Favor can be explained. It can only be experienced. It cannot be explained verbatim. What do we call gospel? Gospel is like, it's gotten from two words, good and spell. It's like a spell. That thing called spell. It's not really a bad word like that. That's a good spell, and that's a bad spell. Spell is not just strictly bad. So that's when something is a good spell upon you. That's a proverb of favor. You know what they call spell? If that thing is upon you, even if I moved you from here, I moved you to United States of America, there will be something on you. Men will just be avoiding you. They will want to help you. They'll get to the point of helping you, and they'll dispense the whole thing. So there's something called favor. It's the opposite of this thing called bad spell. That's what they call faith. That's what we call gospel. So it's a spell that is cast upon a man that gives a fragrance, that makes human being want to help them. Angels are not only people that they are not just winged spirits or winged humans. You know, angels have human body. Angel can descend on earth like men. Remember when the fallen angels dropped on earth, they began to have sex with the daughters of men. You know, they are not spirits that had wings. No, they are human beings like us. Human beings like us. Remember the angels that visited Abraham? They were eating literal normal human foods. Those are angels. They are, don't think everybody you see on the street are normal. Everybody's not normal. There are angels among these people. They are angels. So favor is that thing that God can put upon a man that will make you attract angels in human form. That will make you attract these beings called angels. That's why Bible says, do not be insensitive to be hostile to strangers, because by so doing, some have entertained angels unaware. So that place is not talking about spiritual angels. It's talking about physical human beings like Paul. God likened them to be angels. That's a grace for favor. That's a grace of favor that can come upon a man injected like a drug. He knows exactly where to go. It's we go and sort out major things in your life. Favor can open doors that no man can shut. Favor will take time to land upon you, but when he comes. Favor is more than, it's not respecter of location. It's no respecter of your certificate. If your certificate were that thing that was supposed to put favor upon you, most of you should have spent, the one that you spent 20 years, two decades doing by now should be giving you a dimension of favor that human beings cannot explain. So therefore, it's a point. Education was just a mere, if I say it's a mere distraction to put us on the spot and decoy us away from the real thing that works, it will look like I'm saying heresy. you know, that's something we're supposed to press for. That's an oil of God that we are supposed to press for, that brings favor upon a man. No man ever meets God. The evidence that you met God is that the fragrance of God called favor is supposed to flow on your head naturally. When you carry God, when you carry this thing, this concept, this ideology, this being called God, when you carry that thing called God, human beings, they must gather around you somehow. They must want to see you. They must want to relate with you. Anything that is on your body that is making people repel you, people want to help you at a point, they just turn back and say they don't want to help you again. You carry the opposite of this thing I'm talking about. Favor is that thing that comes upon a man. Even if I transport you, even if I move you from here, I put you in a different country that you don't even have anybody, that thing will still, it will still show. It will still show. In Israel, those days, there's a particular, in the Jewish culture, there's always a particular rite, I mean, ordinance they do before they can just give people right hand on fellowship. These are the carcass of no more didash kalos. These are the carcass of teachers of teachers. These are ordinations done to endorse you as teacher of the law. You know, in those days, to endorse you as an apostle of the gospel of Jesus. They had carcass, they had protocols that must be observed. You can't just break into them and join them. No, it doesn't work like that. But there's a man called Paul that never met Jesus on any day. I can't even judge if he was alive when Jesus was alive. I don't know. I've not studied theology. I can't tell you exactly if Paul was alive when Jesus was alive. But what I do know is that he never met Jesus one-on-one. And when this guy showed up from after his conversion, there was a special grace upon this man that he had inclination to things that Jesus never even completely said. You know, Jesus wanted to teach a lot of things, but he said, you are not able to bear it now. He said, when the Holy Spirit comes, he will tell you more about this thing. So Paul was sent to teach things that even Jesus never said, such that he dumbfounded the disciples that actually slept on the bosom of Jesus. They had to ask him, guy, come, you are not with us. How did you know these things? So when that guy showed up with all his exploits, they just perceived that, come on, man, this guy is different. There is a grace upon this man. They did not question him. They did not take him through all the protocols. They gave him right there and then the right hand of fellowship. And from there, he began to mingle with the apostles. This guy never met Jesus, but he wrote 2/3 of the New Testament. But he wrote 2/3 of the New Testament. Jesus gave his kingdom. He handed over his ministry to Peter, but somehow, he slipped into the hand of Paul. Favor can make you overtake anybody. Favor can make you overtake anybody. It can take a man from the back and put them in front. It's not about your background. It's not about where you came from. It's irrespective of who your parents were. As a matter of fact, don't hide your parents from anybody. That is a place God can take you to, and it will be obvious that this is a white path that came out from a black pot. So never hide your black pots. Your parents are your black pots. Never hide your black pots. Keep it for reference purpose. There's something coming upon your head that is going to make it obvious to the world that God is behind this person. I just ended the call of a friend of mine. He's also a real estate guy in Lagos, and he confided in me personally. He asked me personally, guy, we know you. Are you getting fundings for these things you are doing? How are you getting fundings? He wanted me to tell him, and it dawned on me on that spot, not up to 30 minutes ago, that come on, I'm working in a dimension that even me, I don't have total explanations for. What God can give a man in a year can actually take, is something that should take at least 10 years for human expertise, for all your connection, whatever hard work you do to get you there. Favor can shorten somebody's speed. Yes, at the end of the day, it takes the same time Because if you start working and you ignore favor, if you start working for 20 years and you ignore favor, and me, I did not work, I did not, you know, expand the same energy like you are doing. I sat with the world pressing for this thing called favor. I pressed for it for 17 years. Honestly, in 3 years, it will take me just 3 years to collapse everything you have achieved for 20 years to make us meet at the same point, or if I will not even pass you. That's something about favor. Something came upon that prophet. How can a man outrun the chariot of a king? In those days in Israel, the chariots of the king were the strongest chariots in town. You can never have a chariot, you can never have a horse that runs faster than the chief's horse. They're going to collect it from you. They will send for it. Remember when Jesus was entering Jerusalem, he sent for the best of the best. He told them to go and get a colt. He needs it. That's how the king of the Jews do. That's how they do then. If you had any horse that is better than the king sent for it and they use it and override you. So it was evident in those days that the king's chariot was the best of the best. But a mortal man, something came upon a mortal man that made him outrun a chariot of a king. And something you call chariot is that thing that human beings sit on and they give the horses to ride upon. So if you want a chariot to be fast, you don't put just one horse. They put like 2-3 horses so that the synergy, the combination of those of the pull energy is going to propel, you know, the chariots faster than if one was doing it. The law of synergy. That's what happens then. So imagine the speed of 3 horses put together. A horse is more than, it's almost a ton. That's almost a ton. Imagine the sheer power a single horse of a king can generate, let alone 3 of them, and how one man can outrun them. These are strange dimensions of the spirit. If you think you've seen it all, there's something called favor. God is someone that is inexhaustible. You cannot say you have seen all of God. I don't care the record that has been set. I don't care what anyone has done. There's something called favor that can show another dimension of God that human being has never seen upon the surface of the earth. If God is done showing everything he has in his arsenal, he will have wiped up this planet. He will have ended the earth. The fact that God has not ended the earth means there are still dimensions that God is set to show humanity that is yet to show. It's not that he's not ready, but he's looking for souls, he's looking for vessels that will tap into this thing, that will be recipient, that will be recipient of this thing called favor. It takes time. God is not just going to spread favor on everybody. No, because the gift of God is without repentance. When God gives you, he never collects it back. So it takes his time, as a matter of fact, before he drops this thing upon a man. If he can just dare to see a generation that will consist them, if he can just dare to see a generation that can sit with the world, if he can dare see a generation that will practice kingdom principles, this thing called favor will just be smeared on you. You will never know the day you walked into it. You just find out you are there. A lot of people want to ask me, how did I get here? And how did I break through? You know that thing, what breakthrough is making it look like there is a wall in front of you, and there is a day you carry hammer and pull down the wall, like the whole wall of Jericho, and you walk through. No, there's no such thing as breakthrough, like as it were. You know, one day you just find out that you are in Canaan land. The routes you passed, how you got there, you can be saying just a little bit of it, but you can never pinpoint that this is the day I crossed. No, you just find out you are there. You know, today is the tomorrow that we hoped for yesterday. Now you are in today. That same today that we are in is the same tomorrow we spoke about yesterday. The difference between yesterday and tomorrow, I mean yesterday and today, is just maybe 1 second. 11:59 and 59 seconds, you just cross into today. Such that you will never know if you were not watching time that you crossed. That's the parable of favor. Favor is that thing that breaks principles. You know, this is a world of norms. This is a world of norms. We have so much norms. We have so much principle. human, there's so much principle in mathematics and physics and all of that. Everything in this life is hinged upon laws and principles. But favor, if you ignore, if you sat with the word of God, if you sat with that concept called God, if you sat with that divine being called God, he can smear something on you that will make you violate all these things and emerge like you were in different species of Homo sapiens on earth. God is the unquestionable God. He can raise men that will become unquestionable on earth. God does things that marvel humans. He can raise men that will do things that will marvel their fellow humans on earth. It just takes time. It takes consistency. It takes your willingness to sit with this world. Your unwillingness to sit constantly with these things will make you a vain, will make you vain men on earth and not great men. I was studying one day and Jesus personally told me, he said, "Guy, guess what? I was never God from the beginning and I was almost going to shut the mouth of Jesus. Like, don't say that. How can you say that?" And he took me to John 1, where in the beginning was the world. The world was with God. And the same God was, in the beginning was the world. The world was with God and the world was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. And after him, there was nothing made that was made. Read that, see that place. In the beginning was the word was with God. Comma. And because the word was with God, the word became God. So it's a process. That person called Jesus was never God from the beginning. He sat with Jesus he was not there from the beginning, just like some of you are sitting with me now, learning and learning and learning and learning. One day, that person called Jesus just switched and became God. And became God. I swear, Lucifer never met Jesus in heaven. No, he never knew that person called Jesus. Because Jesus was in the process of learning, staying with God the Most High. They never met. Till today, Lucifer, devil, had never met Holy Spirit. He never met Jesus. He was just wondering that, that's a lie. That's why what Lucifer wants to do today, what devil wants to do today, is to condemn the credibility of Jesus Christ on earth. Because, and it's not his fault, he never met him. So the whole concept of Jesus is like a lie. He wants to tell you that there's no such thing. Anything God does, he wants to do the opposite. Anything Jesus did on earth, he wants to tell you, no, it's not true. And it's not his fault, he never met him. So what am I trying to say? That thing called being God smelled on Jesus after billions of years of staying with the Father. In the beginning was the world was with God, and the world was God because the world was with God. You become what you stay with. How can I stay with the world? I think of kingdom of God, of Jesus, 15 hours a day. How do you expect me and you to be the same? How? Well, talk to me. Even if I stayed at home and did nothing, men give me close to 500,000 almost every month. I just see dangerous alerts from all over the world. Favor is a dangerous thing that will make you never lack in your life. How many alerts have I seen from outside the world in foreign currencies? Someone will just wake up and say, Holy Spirit, tap them to send me their tithe from UK. How many times? They will send it, you will see at least 100,000. I'll be wondering how. I pressed for this thing for 17 years. I always questioned status quo. I knew there is more to this thing that we do, we call Christianity. I just knew somewhere in my heart that there's more. I just knew there was more. You need to be tired of norms. There's more to what we do. There's something called favor, guys. There's something called favor. There's something called favor. How can you get favor there? If you understand that there's something called favor, how can we get favor? You can never get favor by prayer. Just forget it. Just forget it. People like to quote what Jacob did to the angel. The struggle, spread, blah, blah. Do you know what Jacob has done? Do you know the sacrifice these guys have done? When he was going to meet his brother, do you know how many things he packed to go and give him? And his brother met him halfway and told him, Augusta, don't bother. Even me, I brought things to come and meet you. Because when they saw Jacob, them, they just thought he came to dupe them again. He said, no, I came with peace in the name of the Lord. He brought things to them. this guy is a giver. This guy is someone that released things. You couldn't have given back to a kingdom shaker like Joseph if you were not a giver. There's something your giving can do to your progenies, to your offspring. You will never visit my mom. Even if it's a salt, my mom will give you. Even if it's matches, my mom will give you. No wonder she gave back to someone like me. Even if you didn't see it on you, just a generation after, it can never skip your generation. Favor can never skip your generation if you're a giver. They have deceived us for so long. They will think, they will say it's prayer, it's fasting. It's not prayer, it's not fasting. It's not. I'm ready to be controversial in this kingdom. I'm ready to be controversial in this 21st century. I want to be the most controversial person. Jesus was not someone that was self-explanatory. You have to look at Jesus and wish him dead sometimes, because he just came and more or less broke almost all the principles. There was a day he was just speaking. He said, I've not come to break the law. I've come to point out the deeper meanings of it. And you know that point when you get to, even you know that you are breaking law, you've changed almost everything people knew. The Pharisees hated him. They just wanted him to die. You know, because he came and switched almost everything people believed in. Some of what they've taught us is not correct. I repeat, they are not correct. Favor will be smeared on you relative to your quantity and quality of sacrifice. God is more ready to deliver these things to humanity, but he's looking for a heart that will never be stingy. He's looking for people he can put favor on, that can smear it upon others. He's looking for people he can deposit blessing on and will distribute it to others. God is looking for distributors and not warehouse. Some people carry God's blessing and store it in the warehouse for their own consumption alone. God is looking for people who put favor on and they will let it extend to human race. So what qualifies a man, therefore, is not prayer. If it was by prayer, some of these prayer cities would be jammed with favored people. And they've been praying this thing for years and years, yet we cannot see it on them. If it was by prayer alone, show me the result of the ones you prayed for. Donkey of years. Show me. Be glorified forever. Seek you now and forever. Be glorified. Be ready to do sacrifice. Favor is never coming on you without sacrifice. Anything you see the devil doing, that's a replica of God. Till now, everything devil knows, everything he's doing, he learned it from the kingdom of God. He learned it by proximity with the Father. Drop that thing. Till today, devil is a son of God. Go and quote me anywhere. Devil is a son of God. The power devil is using, he got it from God. It's a power of God. It's a corrupted power of God. He has nothing. His job is to steal, kill, and destroy. Look at the first word, his missions. The first one is steal. So it means he has nothing. Everything he has, he stole it. If devil is doing sacrifice, common sense should tell you that this is the concept you stole from the kingdom. How dare you in your kingdom think you can get things by prayer? No, it's no. These things are sacrificed. Men of God don't just know how to tell you so that they won't be looking like some people, they won't be looking like beggars to you. Some of them deceive you by prayers. And when you depart from their presence after praying for you, they nyimu on you and be like, see this one, you think it's by that. Some of them are not telling us the truth, not because they don't want to tell us the truth, but they don't want you to look at them funny. Wake up to these things, guys. I'm not joking. At this level, I need nothing from any man again at this level. Honestly. I've gotten to a level Bishop Oyedepo got to many years ago and declared to the world he can never be poor alone. If I sat with what God gave me in 365 days and I tried to convert it to money, three generations after me cannot finish eating the money. I'm telling you the truth. Just to sit down and be selling them one by one. It's more than the GDP of 5 local governments in Nigeria. I don't want to say a country. You know, these are things I sat with for years and years and years. Something inside me told me that this thing is possible. It told me that there's a dimension that can come upon a man that will make me overtake everybody that looked like they've gone ahead of me. I finished school in the explosion of the banking industry, where my guys were getting jobs in banks. Everybody was exploding. I did not get nothing. It was looking like, oh my God, how did my life look like this? I was just telling someone who just visited me how one of our first class guys will always meet me and with a seat for me to pray with him. Those were guys we were looking at high up in class, and we will beg them to teach us stuff in tutorials. It's not by what you know. It's not by academic excellence, guys. You can be chartered and your life can be battered. You can have more degrees than the thermometer, and your life is degraded. There's something called favor. There's something called favor. You will never get this thing by sleeping on mountains. You will never get this thing by 40 days prayer and fasting, sleeping on snake territories. You get favor by sowing. You get favor by believing in prophets of God. You get favor by sacrifice, by dangerous ones. At the time, you have to transcend the level of sowing and crying, because you will have seen so much result that you'll be excited to give. I'm in that stage now. There is nothing. The only thing I know there is that after Abraham, God is not sending anybody to kill their child again. So I know God will not be sending me to kill my child. He's not be sending me to sacrifice my wife. But after that, there is nothing I cannot give any human being except I'm not led. Apostle Selman looked at me and said, "You, this young man, there is a grace upon you that is making you obey this sacrifice and givings you do." God tells every man all these things, but not every man is empowered to obey. And that day I understood that, wow, could this be true? Apostle cannot preach in 5 places, in 3 places, without mentioning our testimony. You may trivialize it because it's happening to someone you know, it's something very close to you, but out there is a major testimony that has shaken the kingdom of God. 21st century. How will a man look at me and give me 450 hectares behind Bishop Oyedepo's land in Canaan land? How? We are currently outsourcing for foreign investors that will come and build a mega city in that place. And I'm just thinking on my own, maybe just my own thought, maybe it's still the same me that God will raise to build a mega city in that particular place. That place is worth billions of naira. I don't even want to mention it. Do you know what 1 hectare is? 1 hectare is 15 plus or 50 by 100. So multiply that by 450. Not to even talk about what God gave in Abuja alone. These things happen in 365 days. You can't meet me last year and meet me this year and say I'm the same person. It's not possible. You have to open your mouth and your lung will almost drop out of your mouth. If you see what God did for me, it's not because I'm the first person God has done it for, but in the space of time, how those things happen is beyond the explanation of human being. Even if you did blood money, you can never have what I will have in 1 year. You can't. It's not possible. Isaac had to ask his son, how did you get this thing? How? Even me, your father, that was directly connected to Abrahamic order of blessing, I didn't get this thing, so quickly like this. And Jacob responded, your God brought it to me quickly. I love that word, quickly. Quickly. It's called favor. David was not the best in his time. How will a bush boy, how will a shepherd boy kill Goliath? This is a guy that passed the test of sacrifice. If you have not passed the test of sacrifice, you are not qualified to carry favor. If you have not done what Abraham did, you are not qualified to demand for Abraham's blessing. Quit singing that song, Abraham's blessings are mine. If you have not questioned your life and questioned whatever you do and sat with exactly the same things Abraham did, you are not qualified for Abrahamic blessing. God and Abraham were friends for a very long time, for more than 9 decades, until a day Abraham was able to prove to God that, yes, I can be a carrier of favor. He obeyed all the instruction of giving, and God looked at him one day and said, now I know. That is, I don't think I will ever be able to preach a complete message without mentioning that word. Now I know. Now I know that you love me. So what have they been doing all the while? That's my question. So God can be your friend and give you nothing for 90 years. Trust me. You can be a friend of God. You can serve. You can claim to serve God and not be a carrier of these things. 80% is just the same with the parietal law that I just shared on my wall. 80% of church members are just bench warmers. They don't understand the kingdom. They have no idea of what the pastor is saying. They are just saying, write on, pastor, preach it. All these things are lies. They get out of church. They do nothing about it. We see no result in their life. It's not because some of them are still undergoing process, I understand, but 80% are not just getting it. It's when it's time to pray about your witches. That's when you see people remove their heels, remove their wig, put it aside, and start shaking head like, you know, all those things. Devil is not dying soon. Get it? Devil is the messenger of God. Die. All this is a waste of time. Devil is not dying now. He's the last enemy to be destroyed. Go read your Bible. He's not dying. Kill yourself. You rather die trying to make devil die. You know what I mean? You need to see that with principles. Learn what works. I have sat down for 17. You can never question a man who have tried almost everything for 17 years and is telling you what works. How will I give out one land that was my all? I know the conversion of one land, some people have given more than it in their lifetime, but they didn't get the result I gave. What is the difference? The difference is because that was all I had. The quality of it was so high in the presence, in the eyes of God. God can never deny that I did not give my best. And in the first three months after that, God gave me 9 properties and 1 estate. I need to update Apostle now. That testimony is very old, very, very old. When I hear it now, I just feel like covering my eyes. That's not me. I don't know how many estates I have now. I lost count. I just did a countdown of our land use now, and I saw 11 there. And those are estates. If you come back in the next 5, 6, 7 years, you'll see they are full blown estates. I will go to my boss's site last year. If he doesn't come to site to give me transport money to go home, I will never be able to go home. There are times I walk from that site, I walk to the main road and get a cab. I will jump on cab, I have no money, tell the house help to wait for me on the road in Gwagalada with 200 naira to pay the bike. You know, when some of you say you go through things, I just look at you like, if I tell you what I've been through, you've not gone through nothing. At least you are still on social media, you are browsing, you are using big phone, you are making your hair, you are doing lipstick, you are taking selfie, bending your hips, taking photo shots like you were one superstar, and you say you are going through. Some of you, you say you are going to calculate the worth of the hair you are making. It's up to 10K. You're not going through nothing. You're going through nothing. I'm talking about when you and your wife will trek almost 30 minutes to ATM to go and withdraw 500 naira. You'll be speaking in tongues so that ATM will pay you 500 naira. And when you hear the sound of the ATM start counting 500 naira, it was like breakthrough. What are you saying? Don't think we just arrived, I just came here. Don't think he was born like that. No, don't think that's his destiny. Anybody can be here, anybody. Look at Chinelo. Look at her. The first salary she got. I'm not telling you to go and be showing your money to me. Don't do me like MMM. Because that's what people have started doing now. Don't tell me to Mavro. I'm not Mavro. If you get nothing, don't come and hold me. Chinelo Kari, this is a girl that honors me. It's very obvious to all. I just don't like mentioning her name all the time so that everybody will not be feeling like she's the only one. I'm a very sensitive father. I know how I handle my children. You should never show anybody that this is your, favorite children or not. I don't do that. But when there is results, there's no way we have to talk about it. We have to talk about it. It means she understands something. There's something she knows. You climb or you men assess greatness based on what they know. Information is what elevates men to manifestation. Men rise to greatness on the wings of knowledge. There's something she knows. All her alawi, she carried it just 1 week ago, sank everything to me. The month just ended. That should be last week, I'm very sure. She sank every 17,500 there about. I'm like, who has this alert? What? How are you going to live? How are you going to survive? She told me the camp manager had been studying her for since the day they started that camp. And they drew her and asked her, come, I've been watching you for 3 weeks now. Where do you want me to post you to? You know, is it charm? Is it jazz? They don't laugh in camp. They don't send you in that camp. People die in camp. They don't care. They just called her, come, where do you want me to post you to? And in her mind, she has been picturing Ministry of Finance. It's Sokoto State. What are you talking about? When you sow, even you are expectant. You rehearse your future. This is what I do. People always catch me speaking alone. This is what I do. I rehearse testimonies. I rehearse what I want to happen to me. I'll be rehearsing what I will tell you. And this will happen. Because I know I planted the seeds. I can only expect the harvest. I can't plant okra and be expecting yam. I'm a stupid farmer. You know, it's what you sow that you reap. They asked her, where do you want to work? Where do you want to be posted to? How can they ask a man like that? What kind of question is that? He said, Ministry of Finance. A posting letter came out to the Ministry of Finance that is there. And she will get this. She will still learn. She will still do the principles that we taught her. And she will still go and honor the Minister of Finance there or whatever is the head of finance there. And go and do exactly the things that we've been teaching her. And they will appoint her one day. Don't be shocked one day you see this girl becoming the Minister of Nigeria. These things are is in ladders. If you learn these things, it will work. Greed can kill men. Greed can put men on the spot. Anything you cannot walk away from, you are not permitted to walk into it. These are the laws of favor, guys. I can go on and on for weeks like this without opening Bible. It's not in the bulk of the Bible I quote for you. Even if I quote 15 scriptures now, you will never go and sit down and read them. So this was how the words that became the words of the Bible were normal words of great men that they just flowed like I'm flowing like this. It's just like what I'm saying, someone should be transcribe it into letters. That's what how Bible emanated. Jesus was just flowing like this. That was what he converted into Bible. The same inspiration that wrote the Bible will make a man be flowing in the same direction. And you'll never enter this realm until you have sat with that same template that empowered the writing of the word by the Spirit. These are things that bring favor, guys. These are things that bring favor. Don't wait till you have. We don't have now. I mean, we are not giving now because we have. We have now because we have given
in the future.
I mean, in the past. And we keep giving. I saw an old woman coming out of... I was coming out of yesterday, or day before yesterday. I saw an old woman. This woman is very aged. She was just picking things on the floor. And I called her and I gave her 1,000 naira. This was the same woman I saw sometimes last year. She was hoeing outside the fence of the estate, and I remember I gave her everything in my pocket. I was going for a business deal that day. I gave her 4,000, everything in my pocket. That single act on that particular day, you can sow into longevity. You can never die. You can never die young. Your life cannot just be wasted anyhow. This is how favor is gotten. You see a favored man, you walk up to them instead of hating up on them, instead of them saying, I'm older than him. Are you crazy? Is it my age? Is Jesus the oldest man on that? How old did Methuselah spend on that? Only one verse was written for him. Jesus spent 33 years on that. Till now, the whole world have not recovered from his coming. I'm older than him. Really? Is it by that? You look for a career for these things and put more and sow into their life. That is how you get it. Money is a spirit. It can connect things. I hate passionately, and I know Chinelo hates it more than me. When you go on my wall, you are typing, I tap, I connect. Is it on Facebook they used to connect? You need to wake up. It is given to man to die once. After that is judgment. You will never live a double life. Reincarnation is not possible. It is given to man to die once. If you live here, that's it. And you can never determine the day you die, except some of you. Some people that have risen by the spirit, they know how long they will spend on earth. I know it's more than your imagination. Don't worry about that. That's A level. Just face the one that you understand. So if by chance anything happens to you now, vroom, you leave this earth, you will get to heaven, and you look down earth, you will be seeing things that you should have become, what you should have done to connect to those things and have them, and you didn't do them. And you will see the pastors that taught you that it's only by prayer. You feel like slapping them from heaven. I'm telling you these things now. You agree now or you don't agree. One day you get to a realm that you don't have access to these things again. And that's the time you wake up, and it will be very late. You need to embrace these things. You need to do these things. You need to wake up and make sure it works for you. Thank you for joining us. I just feel like talking to us today. My name is Shekun Daniels. I call myself JDB. That's Jesus Donkey Boy. Jesus rode on a particular coach and entered Jerusalem. Never enter your Jerusalem barefooted. You have to look for a coach to enter. You have to look for a coach. Jesus understood this thing. And people were laying clothes on the floor. People are laying clothes on the floor, laying palm fronds. They were shouting, screaming, Hosanna. That donkey will have been stupid to think it's him they are laying clothes on the floor for. He should have the understanding that it's the person sitting on it that is making them lay clothes on the floor and palm fronds. So I'm that donkey. I have the understanding that it's not me people are honoring. All day I have seen you in my dream that you are seeing. It's not me you are seeing. It's Jesus that is on me. They're just borrowing my body. Because as I speak to you right now, Jesus has no permission to come back to this planet again. Except the world come to an end. I will come and sit on the throne of David to reign for 1,000 years. But as he is now, he's been glorified already. If he comes to this earth, he can't land on this earth. He has to use human body. So since he cannot operate on that again, he has empowered and delegated power to some of us. So we are legislating here on his behalf. That's why you see me in your dreams. It's not me you are seeing. I'm at home sleeping. I have no idea what is happening. I have no idea. If I say I know, I'm just deceiving you. So that's it. It's Jesus. So God be with you. Happy are you if you know these things and you do them. Happy are you if you know these things and you do them. Happy are you if you know these things and you do them. Some people know them, they never did them. You will not get results. It's not in the knowing. Some people just want to know and go and argue about revelation out there. You're a stupid person. Because people don't rise up based on revelation. People are respected. Sons are waiting for manifestations, not revelations. Maybe I should say that again. I say sons of men are waiting for manifestations. I mean, creatures are waiting for manifestation of the sons of God, not the revelations of the sons of God. A lot of you have revelation that you cannot produce the manifestation that should naturally follow it. Revelation without manifestation is just mere frustration. Anything you cannot produce result for, you do not understand it. You may know, you know something does not mean you understand it. Anything that is, I mean, this equation in mathematics. If you know it, you know it. If we change the parameters, you know the formula, you can always duplicate the result anywhere, anyhow. That's what they call understanding, that your eyes of understanding be enlightened. The first time, if you meet God, the first thing he wants to do is to enlighten your understanding. When Paul met Jesus, the first thing that happened to him was scales fell from his eyes. If scales have not fallen from your eyes for you to understand these deep mysteries of God, you will never ascend to where giants are. You just end up a vain man. I'm afraid. I have to tell you the truth once in a while. My name is Olusegun Daniels, Jesus Donkey Boy. I am JDB. Always here to wake up the sleeping giants and pull you to the very thing God has proposed you to be on earth. I'm trying my best to be a balanced preacher. I'm not here to preach on prosperity. I'm not here to do holiness alone. I'm not here to do relationship series. A time is coming. That's what Jesus told me. That I will not have to move from living faith to deeper life because I want to learn holiness. I will not have to migrate from living faith to prayer city in MFM because I want to learn about prayer. God is looking for he's looking for beings that will sit with him and learn all these things and be a complete system. What we call the body of Christ. Do you know, people just say, this guy is a system. They really don't understand what that word system means. In biology, if you study what they call system, system is a collection of organs. Organs is a collection of tissues. Tissue is a collection of cells. And cell is an aggregate of other micro bodies called atoms, this, that, that. So, before you become a system, you have to be a collection of things. So what we see in the body of Christ today, I mean what we see today is just the arm of Christ, leg of Christ, lap of Christ. We've not seen the complete body of Christ at his word. So you know God talks God deals with generation in a particular special way. There was a time he poured out moves of the Spirit in topics. God gave Bishop Oyedepo faith and he ran with it. That is exactly what he's running with. He gave Kumuli holiness. He ran with that holiness. He gave Olukoya prayer. That one ran with it. But this generation, Jesus told me personally, I don't know if he has told you. He said he's looking at raising men that will have a collection of all these things together. And he's sending me number one to be a collection of all these things. That's why you can tell from what I do that I'm a very rounded guy. I don't know one and not know the other. I'm not boasting, I know everything. But to my very best, I'm trying to gather all these principles for you so that you not have to move from our church to another place because you want to learn about prayer. We'll do everything right there and there. That's what they call the body of the Christ. That's the complete picture of the body. And that's the complete explanation of the person called system. I hope you understand it now. Don't let me start another topic. Grace for favor is what we just spoke about. I hope that blessed you. God is your strength in Jesus' name. Everybody came online today. If I start now, I cannot even end it. So much people. I appreciate you all. I have some visitors in your house. I have Godwin here. He came to visit me on site. I have, what's her name? Yeah?
Joy.
She came from Lokoja. These are guys who came to visit me on site today. The site is so hot and, you know, I just want to talk to some people and sit inside the AC. God bless you in Jesus' name. Have a lovely time. We love you. We honor you. We celebrate you.